Okay, today we are starting cascading style sheet CSS. Okay, yeah. Okay, for writing a style sheet, that style command should be followed. This should be included in the header section. Okay, style link. If you want to create an external link, okay, external style sheet. Okay. If you want to create as external style sheet and then link to the document, link to the HTML page, then this is the link section. If you want to write the style sheet within the HTML page, that you need to add this style in the head section. Okay, let's see how to write a external style sheet file or how to include a style sheet in the HTML page itself. Okay, okay, by default, if I run these commands, h1 style color equals to blue, and then this is blue heading, paragraph style color equals red, this is a red paragraph. Okay, okay, right now I am clearing everything. I have pasted only these two lines. Okay, in this place we have added this color style color equals to blue, and then whatever the paragraph, this paragraph color is red. Right now, let's run this one, save, refresh. Okay, this heading one is a blue color, this one is red color. Now, if I remove this, save, let's see, the color will be changed. Refresh. Okay, now I want to put all paragraph color. Right now, Control Z. Okay, this heading one, whatever the this text heading one include, okay, this is a blue color. Even if I added this heading one in some other place, this is also something, second heading, save. Every location I want, we need to add the style color blue, even 1000 lines are there, we are adding style color blue everywhere. That means this something coding is increasing. Okay. Instead of writing the style color blue, all the locations, we'll define a style sheet here. Okay, let's see what is the style sheet. In the under header section, we need to write a style. Okay. Copy. Oh, under head section only. Okay, body. Body background color is blue. Okay, power blue. And then this H1 header will be blue. Okay, I can remove this because I have already included the year. Okay, same kind is already P paragraph will be the red. It's already defined. We need to here. This also H1. It's already okay. I have already added here. If I write H2, okay, let's see. Let's run this one first. We'll add some more thing. Okay. Save. See, I didn't include that style color, anything. I didn't include here. I just included in the style. This style will be applied in all the lines. Okay. Wherever the H1 is there, wherever the paragraph is there, wherever these tags are available, these formatting will get added. Not only color, you can add many things. Okay. Let's see only color. You see background colors light blue added, and then these are okay. Even if I add any other text, suppose something okay, I have added something like this. Save. Again P, I have added another paragraph. Then this will also get same color. Where it is defined? This is defined in the style sheet. Okay. Right click, refresh. You see this paragraph. This paragraph color also red. Okay. This heading is blue. Let's add another thing. Let's go to H2. Okay, now heading 3. Now heading 3 is not defined here. It is defined now. Then the color will be as usual. Black will come. Oh, till now we didn't save this. Oh, it's saved now. You see blue, this H3 heading 3 is not formatted with a red color or any color. You can mention this one H3 also. You can add H3. This will also color equals to orange. Okay, you can put some other color. You can see here. Refresh. You see it's changed. Okay, whatever heading 1 will go for will format as blue, paragraph red, heading 3 is orange. Okay, how many you can keep? You can keep. Okay, all this H1, the whatever the corresponding tag data will be the same format, whatever it, the format it may be. Okay. Okay, this one I have added, inserted in the header section. Okay, what if I want to write the external style file so that I can use this style file in all the HTML pages? Yes, you can use. You can put one style in the entire code. entire all HTML pages. Okay, just cut. Okay, save. We need to save it as CSS. You need to select all files. This is called CSS. Okay, cascading style sheet extension. Save. Okay. Now you can do external link to that that file. This is called link. Under header section only we need to write the style.css we need to include. Okay, now let's try this. Let's save. I didn't include any style sheet. Then you see the color. Refresh. You see all black, no background. Background color. No, if I include the style, you need to add correct style.css. This is style.css, no? This is style.css. Both should be in the same place. Test.html, style.css. See, test.html. Style.css, both should be in the same folder, then only it works. If you want to put a remote full path, you can put C colon users jswita something. Right click, refresh. You see? Blue. This is something. Orange color, blue color. Okay. You see in the style, body background color equals to power blue. This is not why this is not highlighting. Okay, you can add some other thing also, it will be possible. This is external style sheet. Okay, external style sheet I have linked in this HTML dot test.html. okay, I can do the same thing in the with other document also. Let me open another file. This style sheet you can use for all the I am including the same style sheet. Okay, style sheet, same style sheet I have added in the first dot HTML. Instead, this also it will work. This is paragraph. I see paragraph here in the style sheet. H1, H3 is there. H5 instead of H5, let's do H1. Save. Okay, let's go to first.html. Let's open. Do you see? We got the color changes, and then this one, home contact about, this will be Okay, division. That's why it is coming there. Okay. Home contact about. Okay, because of style sheet, these two got colored. Okay. Because we have added. Okay, if you want to remove style sheet, then it will not. Okay, I have commented this line. Save. Then check. The style sheet is commented out. Okay. There is no color. If you remove these comments, if you add style sheet, whatever the styles available in this place, formatting, whatever it may be, either color blue or anything, this will also. Refresh. Okay, what we have done, we have included the single style sheet, external style sheet in two scripts, same style. This also I have included. I am able to get the format, whatever the styles formatting available here. This script also I have written. The same link I kept in other HTML file also, it is working. Not only two, even hundreds. If we include this style sheet link in any other, even 100 files or so, it will work. Okay. This is how the benefits of the external style sheet. Okay. This is how the external style sheet works. Okay. You can write like this also. This is also same, na? Similar kind of thing. We did a single line. Okay. We have included. This is multiple line. Even you can put not only color, font family, font size, anything you can put. You can put font color, font family, font size in the style sheet itself. Okay. Border 2px, solid, power blue, something. You can put anything. Whatever you keep the styles in the style sheet, it will work. This is how you need to link REL equals to style sheet. And then H reference, you need to put style.css. Okay, let's try to put a full path. Okay. You can put full path as well. It should work. You see, full path also working. Okay, you can use a short path or full path as you wish. Okay, even you can fetch the style sheet from w3schools.com also. That will also work. You can put the HTTP link to get that style sheet also. Okay, as you wish. Either you can put a HTTP link. This will work. Even you put only style.css, it work. Even if you put only short path, if that path is available, that will also work. Okay. this is called a linking, okay, linking to the external sheet. So that if we do only one sheet for entire project, that will be fine. Okay, ideally it is only one sheet, style sheet. Okay, that too we prefer to keep external style sheet. Color, font family, font size, everything works. Let's see font color. I can put a font family, font size, everything. Copy. The style sheet. So that this style H1 font family Vardhana, all these things will apply in the script as well, because this style was style sheet we have linked, as well as this file, both files it will work. Then style sheet I have saved, just to refresh one by one. You see, font size changed. Same file, just to refresh. Here also font size change. Okay. Single. If you want to change the format, you need not change format in all the files. Okay. Only single location you can change in the style sheet. Okay. Okay, I did only this styles. This space I have changed. And then I did a simple refresh in remaining pages, so that these changes has been applied. It not only color, font family, font size, it will work for all the things, whatever format you write. Okay, not only this thing. Okay, let's see in the images. Now yesterday we are in images. Here also they use some style sheet, cascading style sheet. Image width. By default they kept style sheet image width equals to something. You can copy. And the style sheet you can add. Image width equals to 100%. Here width equals to 128 px, height equals to, you can mention something like this. Okay, we need to put a semicolon, then only it works. Save. You can add that image here. If image is not there, it will come this icon. But size I have already defined in the style sheet, 128, 128. Let's see this one. You see, size is 128, 128. Now I want to increase, or else I want to keep the actual image. You can keep. Size is too much big. Okay, let's see, decrease this size. I have decreased the size. Why it is not changing? Yeah, percentage is working. Okay, let's see. Yeah, if we keep percent, it is working. Okay, this is how you can put image parameters in the style sheet. Even the same thing now, if you keep the same thing. The other page also, it will work. Refresh. See, the same thing has been applied for both files. Okay, this is how external style sheet it can help us. Image link. Okay, you can put the SRC. SRC means source where it is. SRC means source where it is. It is present in this folder. Okay, this path. Let's see this floating. I never tried this. Save. See, after image it is coming here, correct? Let's put the actual path. Something after image, it is the line of text is there. This is before image, some text is there, correct? Something it is happening. Okay, these are all image formats. Okay, GIFO, graphics interchange format, and then we use JPEG, Giant Photo Graphic Export Group. These are all file extensions, JPEGs. Okay, GIF, .gif extension, PNG, Portable Network Graphics. This is also another type of image format. SVG, Scalable Vertical Groups. This is also one type of image format, PNG. This format, these two format, and then this format we used to do extensively. Microsoft icons, this will be specific to Microsoft products. Okay, this thing, this these two, and this, only these things we used to do extensively, image formats. Okay, let's see this area in the next session.